Hello and welcome back. This week's topic is on carbohydrates. These are the foods in the U.S. diet, the carbohydrates. Soda, energy drinks, sport drinks, making up the largest part, almost 36% of the diet, with grain-based desserts such as cakes and cookies making up the next one of the next largest parts. Now, just below that, we have our fruit drinks, which includes fruit juices, almost 11%. After that is dairy desserts, frozen yogurts, and ice cream. And then we have just regular candy, off-the-shelf candy, ready-to-eat cereals. And then the sugar that we add to foods, such as sugars and honeys. This isn't in processed foods. Now, the next one is tea, and that does make up 3.5%, but this is teas with added sugar in them. And then breads, almost any breads are going to usually have added sugar. And then all other. So what's in the other category? We have fruits, vegetables. What about things like wild rice or legumes? So there are a lot of carbohydrates that are whole foods that are in a very smaller category compared to a lot of these refined and processed grains. So when we look at carbohydrates, there are two categories, complex carbohydrates and simple carbohydrates. When you think of complex carbohydrates, most people think of breads and pastas. Simple carbohydrates, mostly sugar. We're going to learn about each of these categories. The simple carbohydrates contain monosaccharides and disaccharides. Mono means one, so this is just one sugar, and disaccharide means two sugars. So saccharide, think sac is sugar. Disaccharides, monosaccharides. The complex carbohydrates include starch, fiber, and glycogen. Starch is the plant storage form of sugar. And we'll get into this in a little more detail, but you see this blue hexagonal shape here. This is actually one glucose, which we'll talk about in a minute. But this here, starch, is just a storage form of sugar in plants. So that's how plants store their energy. Fiber is also a link of glucose. It just happens to have bonds that we can't break, so we don't digest this. Glycogen, you can see, is a branched basically package of sugar, and this is how we as humans store our sugar or our energy. Let's take a look at our monosaccharides and our disaccharides, with mono meaning one sugar unit and disaccharides meaning two. Now each of these shapes represents one sugar. So let's start over here with sucrose. So sucrose is made of one fructose and one glucose, and that makes up sucrose, with maltose being made up of two glucose, and lactose being made up of galactose and glucose. So glucose makes up each of these sugars. Now, to help you remember these more, think of sucrose as table sugar, and that is what it is. Table sugar, your cane sugar. Sucrose is one of the most common sugars that we'll find. It occurs a little bit in fruit in nature, but one fructose and one glucose is what makes up sucrose. Now, fructose is fruit sugar. Fruits do have some other sugars. They have a little bit of glucose, a little bit of sucrose, but they're mostly fructose. So when you think of fructose, just F for fruit. So fructose is fruit sugar. Now let's jump over to lactose. Lactose is the sugar that occurs naturally in milk, and it breaks down to galactose and glucose. Malt sugar is maltose, and this is what starch digests down to. When you consume table sugar or sugars that are added to food products, your body is going to break this down into fructose and glucose. When you drink milk, you will consume lactose. Your body will break this down into glucose and galactose. Any starch that you eat or long sugar chains like a maltodextrin is going to break down into maltose. This is also malted barley will have some maltose, and that breaks down just to glucose. What about the complex carbohydrates? Because the previous slide showed our simple carbohydrates. They were just one or two sugar units, right? That's very simple. And let's go back just for a minute. So this glucose unit is what makes up all of our complex carbohydrates. It makes up the starch, the plant storage form of energy or sugar, glycogen, our storage form of energy, one of our storage forms of energy, but our storage form of glucose, and fiber. So these are our three complex carbohydrates. So we start with the glucose. This is the one sugar unit. It's a monosaccharide, a simple sugar. This is the basic unit of carbohydrates. It's in all of our carbohydrates, right? It's in lactose, it's in maltose, it's in sucrose, it's in sugar, starch and fiber and glycogen. This is our basic unit of carbohydrate, glucose. Now this, if we had in our body, when we take in the glucose, we are going to link these together to form what's called glycogen. Now, this is our storage form of carbohydrates. We store glycogen, we store these sugar units in the liver and in the muscle. Now, starch, remember, this is the plant storage form. So when we eat plant food, we're eating the plant storage form of glucose. So again, glucose is linked together. Now, when we consume this or we eat this complex carbohydrate, starch is a complex carbohydrate, it will break down to a simple carbohydrate, a maltose or a disaccharide, and even further to glucose, a monosaccharide. So we have starch, the complex carbohydrate, maltose, a disaccharide, and glucose, a monosaccharide. Now, even though fiber is also a chain of glucose, it has a bond that we cannot break down. Our enzymes cannot digest this in our intestines. So fiber goes through our intestines undigested. Now, soluble fiber, and we'll get to this later, is fermentable or just can be digested by to some extent by bacteria in our colon. But we do not break down these bonds and then absorb these glucose units. So fiber goes through undigested. And even though it does, it still has a lot of health benefits, which we'll get to later.